My name is Nick Leister, and I'm a member of the SolidWorks training team. In this multi-video series, I will show you how to start with SolidWorks as I model a pair of needle-nose pliers. In this video, the first in the series, I'll show you how to model the cylindrical pin that acts as the plier's fulcrum as I introduce you to the basics of SolidWorks. Let's get started. I have SolidWorks open, which I'll use to save my data to the 3D Experience platform. I'll start by expanding the menu bar pull-downs at the top and clicking the pin icon to keep it visible. Now, I'll start a part. To do this, I'll click New at the top of the screen. The new SolidWorks document window opens. SolidWorks allows you to create three types of documents. Parts are 3D components. Assemblies are arrangements of parts and/or assemblies. And drawings are 2D layouts of parts or assemblies. I'll keep Parts selected and click OK. SolidWorks contains several important regions of the user interface. The Command Manager provides access to commands, divided into tabs geared towards specific tasks. The Feature Manager Design Tree displays the features of a part or parts of an assembly and documents the chronological sequence of modeling operations. Tabs across the top provide access to additional managers. The task pane contains several tabs, providing access to a variety of tools. The heads-up view toolbar contains many common view manipulation commands. I'll use it to change the scene to plain white. Finally, I'll use the menu at the bottom to change the parts units to IPS, inch, pound, second. Now, I'll create a 2D sketch to form the outline of the shape that I'll bring into the third dimension. To create this sketch, I'll click the Sketch tab from the Command Manager and click Sketch. Now, I'll select the plane where I'll draw my sketch. I'll click the front plane and the view automatically orients so that I'm looking in a direction normal to the front plane. The icons in the upper right indicate that I'm in the sketch environment. I'll use the commands on the Sketch tab of the Command Manager to draw my shape's profile. I intend to create a cylinder, so I'll sketch a circle using the circle command. When I enter the circle command, the cursor icon changes to indicate the active sketch command. Additionally, the Property Manager tab activates, displaying the circle command's properties. Here, we see there are two ways to sketch a circle. I'll keep the default circle type, which allows me to create a circle with two selections. I'll start the circle by making my first selection at the origin, the red arrow icon that marks the intersection point for the three default planes. An orange point snaps to the origin when I hover over it. I'll click to place the circle center. Move the cursor out, and click again to size the circle. The cursor and Property Manager indicate that I'm still in the circle command. To exit the circle command, I'll click the OK icon from the Property Manager. Relations and dimensions control a sketch's size, shape, and position. Because I started the circle at the origin, SolidWorks automatically creates a coincident relation between the circle center and the origin, as indicated by the small green icon. This relation locks the circle center to the origin. However, the circle's diameter is unconstrained by relations or dimensions, allowing me to click and drag the outer edge to resize it. Under constrained sketch entities display blue. I'll add a dimension to the circle to control its diameter. To do this, I'll click Smart Dimension from the Command Manager. Now, I'll click the circle's outer edge to create the dimension, and click again to place the dimension. A pop-up window appears, allowing me to enter the dimension's value. The diameter of the cylinder will be 3/8 of an inch, so I'll enter 3/8. When I click OK, the circle resizes accordingly. I'm still in the Smart Dimension command. I exited the circle command using the OK icon within the Property Manager, which I could do here. Alternatively, I can use the keyboard's Escape key to exit the command. I'll click the Escape key. The circle's lines are now black, which indicates that the circle is fully constrained. When I click and drag the circle, it does not move. The sketched circle is complete, so I'll click the Exit Sketch icon in the upper right to exit the sketch environment. By default, the sketch remains selected when I exit the sketch environment, as indicated by the light blue color highlighting the sketch in the Feature Manager design tree and the sketch in the view area. I'll click off into a blank area to remove the selection. The sketch now displays gray. Now, I will bring this 2D sketch profile into 3D with an extrude feature. To do this, I'll click the Features tab of the Command Manager and click Extruded Boss Base. Once I select the sketch, the Boss Extrude Property Manager appears. I'm also provided a preview of the geometry. I'll click the depth dimension and enter 0.5 to extrude the sketch by half an inch. I'll click OK. The pin's shape is complete, and I'll explore some processes to manipulate its view. I'll use the heads-up view toolbar, expand the view settings, disable shadows in shaded mode, and activate ambient occlusion, which reflects my view settings preferences. Now, I'll explore some techniques to orient the model's view. To rotate the view, I'll click and hold the middle mouse button and move the cursor. Scrolling the middle mouse button down zooms the model's view in, and scrolling up zooms the view out. I can pan the view by holding the control key on the keyboard while holding the middle mouse button and moving the cursor. I can click the F key on the keyboard anytime to fit the model to the view. I can open the view selector by clicking the keyboard's spacebar to select predefined views. I'll click this facet to show an isometric view. Now, I'll save this part to the 3D Experience platform using a collaborative space and bookmarks I created earlier. Check out the video titled Beginner's Guide to SolidWorks, 3D Experience Platform for SolidWorks to learn more about the platform setup featured in this series. I'll start by expanding the Save dropdown and clicking Save to 3D Experience. The Save to 3D Experience pop-up appears. I'll enter PIN under SW title. This dropdown allows me to select the collaborative space. I have four collaborative spaces to choose from, but I'll keep Nicholas Workspace selected. I'll keep this model organized within the collaborative space with a bookmark. To do this, I'll expand this dropdown and click Select Bookmark, which opens the Select a Bookmark pop-up window. From here, I'll expand the Hand Tools bookmark, select Pliers, and click Apply. The Save to 3D Experience window lists columns for revisions and maturity. These properties automatically populate when I click Save. By default, the revision is set to A, and the maturity state is set to In Work. Finally, I'll click Save and click Close. In the following video, I'll begin modeling the pliers handle while demonstrating sketching and the extrude boss base feature in greater detail. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this content helpful, watch the following video in this series and visit the site below to access the complete SolidWorks CAD Fundamentals playlist.